All right. Hi, everyone. My name is Leah Skerry. I'm the Senior Product Manager in Accessibility here at Unity. I have long brown hair. I'm wearing gray glasses. I have a black zip-up shirt on. I live in Halifax, Nova Scotia, and I'm presenting from my home office. And my pronouns are she, her. So I'm super excited to present today the work that our Unity team has been working on, specifically today looking at our beta release of our API for mobile screen reader support and what we're working on next. So here at Unity, we believe the world is a better place with more creators in it. And our small and mighty team believes that wholeheartedly. And so I just wanted to take a moment to say thank you to this team for the hard work that they put in to make this API possible. And also the team that worked so hard prior to the release of this to help build a dedicated accessibility team, which is a major leap forward for the gaming industry. So we're super excited about that as well. So our API is available right now, and I'll make sure the link is shared so you can access that online. And this is specific for runtime in Android and iOS. And so you can find all of the documentation on our website. So what's possible now and in the future? I'll dive into that. So for our beta, Android and iOS, you can find common roles like button, image, text, as well as basic use cases, as well our navigation gestures, so swipe right and left, activate to double tap, and hierarchy viewer, our debug tool. So at the end of my presentation, I'll also share a demo our engineer Bianca put together where the API is in use, and you can take a look at it through that video as well. In terms of our 2023.3 release, which will happen at the end of the year, you can see a few more functions supported. So increase and decrease gesture, toggle support, scrolling content gesture, as well as our a dismissing gesture, and to come. So beyond what will be released in 23.3, additional mobile functionality that we are looking at is language support, element exclusion, custom actions like rotor, primary actions. So that would be gestures for the main action of whatever specific app you're in, as well as advanced use cases. And then in terms of platform support, what's on our roadmap is desktop support for Windows and Mac, as well as WebGL, and then UI toolkit support. So directly in UI toolkit. So that's all specific in terms of our roadmap for screen reader. If you're interested in other features that we're both considering and working on in accessibility, you can take a look at our public roadmap on our website. I'll make sure that link is available as well. There you can see plan in progress, under consideration, and you can upvote, you can comment on it, and it's super helpful for our team to see what you're looking for in terms of your project. So I highly encourage you to check that out. And we also have our accessibility form, and I will share that link as well. And feel free to post, ask questions, and our team will be sure to get back to you. So that's it. This is the video that you will see shortly. Thank you so much, and thank you for watching.
The first goal of the accessibility team is to add native screen reader support in the Unity runtime. We started with creating an MVP for iOS that supports the basic features of VoiceOver. Our API can now be used to have the UI elements of a Unity application be detected and read by VoiceOver. This has never been possible in a Unity application before. That's what Unity Creator could do with our API at this point. On my iPad, I will activate VoiceOver and open my Unity application.
Screen reader demo. Double tap to open. Screen reader demo.
This application presents a basic settings screen that includes a username input field, a server dropdown, a music toggle, a music volume slider, a save button, and a disabled cancel button. A fast swipe to left to remove VoiceOver to the next accessible element, and the double tap will activate the element. Let's swipe.
Settings, heading.
Let's swipe again.
Username, enter text. Input field. Double tap to edit.
Let's double tap.
Text field is editing, insertion point at start. Use the rotor to access misspelled words.
Now I'm going to go back.
Return. Return. Server, forest. Drop down. Double tap to edit.
Let's double tap to open the drop down.
Server, forest. Drop down. Server, forest.
Let's swipe.
Drop down. Music, switch button. On. Double tap to toggle.
Let's swipe again.
Music volume, 70%, adjustable. Swipe up or down with one finger to adjust the value.
Let's swipe one more time.
Save button. Double tap to activate.
Let's double tap to activate the button.
Save.
Now let's swipe one more time.
Cancel dimmed button.
Here dimmed means disabled. This is the first set of accessibility features out of a long series yet to come. Thank you for listening.